Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. So in my previous video, I have already discussed in detail about texture based image segmentation using entropy. And here is this video. The link I'll be providing in the description box, because this concept you should know before going ahead with today's video. Okay, because today I am not going to discuss something completely new concept. Rather, I am going to show you how we can utilize the same code for any other image, how we can just change some parameters and put the same concept for segmenting other image based on texture. Okay, like here we have taken this particular image back.png, which is already present in MATLAB, right? And at the end of the presentation, I have shown you that we have perfectly segmented the original image into two parts, where both part contains a particular pattern or a particular texture. That's why it is texture based image segmentation. And the central algorithm behind or central concept behind this particular image segmentation is nothing but entropy, which we already studied in our information theory and coding course, right? So let's take the same code and let us try to apply on some other image as well, and let us just try to understand how we can change the parameter so that it can be useful for your problem statement. Okay, where you are using the same code in some another image in some new use case. Okay, so instead of back.png, let me take another image. Okay, fine-tune.png. Okay, let me show you that image first, right? So here we can just take imread-fine-tune.png. This image I'll be providing in the description box. I'll be uploading in GitHub, and that link I'll be providing so that you can take from there and use in for practice purpose. Okay, using your code for practice purpose, right? So let's check if some error we got or not. fine-tune.png does not exist. Sorry, this will be capital png. Okay, so let me just run this particular piece of code, evaluate selection. Okay, let's check our original image. Okay, so this is our original image. You can clearly understand that left side has a particular pattern or texture and right side has completely different pattern or texture. And in between left and right hand side, see my mouse pointer, like this kind of S-shaped boundary is present. So we need to segment the original image based on texture, that is left and right hand side. I hope you have understood the problem statement. So what is the step one? Reading the image, which is already done. No need to change this step. Step two, calculate the entropy filtered image. Okay, this is also remaining unchanged, because again here we are going to use the entropy concept only, because the left hand side entropy, or basically measurement of uncertainty, is different with respect to right hand side, right? So let us check our entropy image. So we can just write figure, sorry, in small letter it will be, okay, figure. Okay, figure, then im show of our e. Okay, that's it. So let's run this particular piece of code and let's check how the entropy filtered image, after calculating entropy for each pixel within considering 9x9 window, looks. So see, it looks like this, and it is quite clear that how we are going to do segmentation. See, left side is darker than right hand side, so we will convert to binary and then we'll create a proper mask, and then we can multiply that mask with our original image to extract the left or right hand side. That's it, right? So what we need to do, the step one is reading the image, step two, get the entropy filtered image, step three is finding the proper threshold for making the image to binary image. Okay, so before going ahead, let me show you the image I. So if I write whose of I, if you see that the image is basically unsigned integer 8-bit and size is 685x689x3, that is, this is colored image. So before converting to binary, always it is better that you start with some grayscale image. So let me convert this to RGB to gray, okay, and then do all kind of computation. It will be remaining same up to this stage. So let me just run once more, okay, and we'll be getting our entropy filtered image. Now to get the proper threshold value, like here I have used 0.8, but always it will not be 0.8, it will be varying according to images to images. Okay, so what we can do to get the idea of threshold value, I can use imhist function, as I have already discussed several times that how you can use the property of histogram to get the idea about the threshold value. So just run this particular piece of code, okay, and let's check how the histogram looks for this particular image. Okay, So for this image, the histogram looks like this. So kind of bimodal shape it is taking. See, it is going upper, then it is going below here, then again it is going upper. So where it is going down? At this particular point, the point is approximately x value is 0.7. So we can choose the threshold value as 0.7. Okay, so instead of 0.8, we have to take 0.7. Okay, and then let's plot the binary image also. So what I can do here, figure, okay, then I am so binary image. Whenever you are developing something, always try to put as much IEM show as possible. Like when we write normal program, maybe you are creating a pipeline in machine learning or big data domain using PySpark or something, always better to use print statement as much as possible while doing development, because you can understand what problem or what is the state of the variables, right? So similarly here, while doing image processing related work, always try to put as much IEM show as possible so that you can understand each stage. Okay, and later you can remove when you are in a good way. Okay, because see, 0.7 we have kept, but we don't know whether it is proper or not, right? So we may need to change. That's why I kept IEM show here. But here we can see from the output that it is quite good. We can easily just remove these small particles, keeping only the large right hand side. Okay, and we can fill the holes also. Okay, so like here we are doing area open based on 1500. I don't think these pixels are that much big. I can reduce this also 1000. Okay, then here once we are doing area open, we are applying structuring element on the rest of the image, and then here closing these some parts, filling holes. So these are almost remaining unchanged. Let me figure directly that I am show hole filling. Okay, hole filling image, let us try to observe directly, because rest part is remaining same like earlier. So here what we can do, let us run this particular part. What is happening? Evaluate selection. Okay, so this particular part, area open, closing, hole filling, all these steps are like earlier only, right? Because we can understand from the thresholded image itself that it is going to be same like our earlier. And see, wonderfully we have got the mask. That's it. So what we can do here, we can keep just remove the unnecessary IEM show now. Okay, wherever we have created, see, original image, let it be. Histogram remove, binarize IEM show, this one also remove. Okay, figure subplot 1, 2, 1. So this is hole filling, this is going to be our right side. Okay, right side, right part, and this is going to be our left part when doing complement and multiplying, right? So let's run the whole code and let's check whether segmentation is done properly or not based on texture. So basically what I am just trying to show you, that how you can use the code as a generalized pattern, whatever I have used here, and put in your own image. See how beautifully right side and left part are separated. But now what I want additionally to show that boundary line also. Okay, so to get the boundary line, what we have to do, I am telling you. So let me go in a new figure window. So we have the hole filling image, right? So this function I have already discussed about earlier also, label overlay. So that one only we are going to use. So let us take this hole filling image and show you that once. So I am show hole filling. Okay, so I am show hole filling. If we do, so this was what we are getting, right? So now to put the boundary, we need to extract the boundary of this image. So perimeter we can compute. Okay, so for that, what we can do, maybe peri equal to bw perim of our whole field image. Okay, and that one, let us see first. Figure I am show peri. Okay, so how the label overlay works, if you want to know, please go through the link given in the description box, because I have already discussed in detail in my earlier video also while discussing texture based image segmentation. So this is what our perimeter is, but this is kind of broken shape. So let's do one thing, let's dilate this also. So I am dilate maybe we can take let's take disk shape structuring element STREL of disk, and maybe the size of disk I am not becoming choosy in this particular perimeter filling, because it is just going to give one kind of indication, that's it. So let's run this particular part and let's check whether we are getting any error or not. No error, and perimeter is also perfectly coming. Now we can put this on our original image. Okay, so let me just remove unnecessary figure windows. Okay, so here also it is removed, and then here what we can do, we can basically overlay, right? So label overlay we can use. So im show label overlay is the function. Okay, pass the original image I, which is our input image, and then we are trying to give some boundary lines based on this perimeter. Okay, and then color also we have to specify. So for that, color map, already discussed in detail, no need to worry about a single line. So you just try to understand the approach what I am doing. I am trying to calculate the perimeter of our two different texture, and that we are putting a second parameter. First parameter is our original image, and what color we want to give for that boundary, that we need to specify. Suppose I want to give yellow color, so red channel 1, green channel 1, blue channel 0, that is nothing but definition of yellow, right? That's it. Now let's run whole code and let's check whether we are able to get the boundaries based on what we actually want. Let's see that, or if we get some error, we will also investigate on that also. So here, this is our original image. This is our right part and left part separated. You can clearly understand it perfectly. Texture based segmentation is happening, and this is our figure 3. See how beautifully the boundary is created, right? You just consider this image. So this is our original image. You can understand, right, that here S shape boundary is present in between two different texture, but how beautifully it is shown using this particular label overlay function. Just you need to pass the original image and the boundary, and what color you want to give on that boundary. That's it. Okay, suppose if I am changing from 110 to 100, what will happen? Basically it will give 100 means what? Red color only. So it will give the, for the boundary, it will be giving only the red color. That's it. No other changes much. See, red color. That's it, right? You can play with this. So this is how, from a generalized pattern of this particular code, which I used for a particular image earlier, that we can generalize. Just we need to choose the threshold value properly. Okay, what, based on what pixel threshold we can choose for area open, just little bit this side changes, and you are ready to use this particular code for your use case, right? So I hope you have understood this particular concept. This is all for my this video. If you find this video helpful, then please like, share and comment. Subscribe my channel if you have not subscribed till now. And don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of my latest videos. Thank you.